Guys, a few weeks back, we just watched together the Chandrayaan-3 launch. We saw the news and I asked you guys, hey, let me know when it lands. You guys told me it would take about, what, 14 days? Something like that. And now we're here with the historic moon landing. Guys, India managed to land in the South Pole of the moon, which nobody has ever done before. So we're gonna check this out and see what the news says.
We
This
can see.
is a historic moment and a proud moment for India. Right now, India is ahead of the world in space, stuff.
We can see the Honorable Prime Minister, Sri Narendra Modi ji, who is here to encourage us, and he is critically looking at the visuals.
How did they get the visuals, though? Who's the cameraman up there?
जी हाँ, आप अपने स्क्रीन पे देख सकते हैं कि हम पाव लैंडर मॉड्यूल
People are applauding. Let
लैंडर
us all
मॉड्यूल
wait
की
to hear from the Secretary Department of Space and Chairman ISRO, Sri S. Somnath.
Amazing.
लैंडर मॉड्यूल पूरी तरह से सेफली और सॉफ्टली चंद्रमा के सतह पे लैंड हो चुका है। ये हम लोगों के लिए बहुत ही गर्व की बात है।
I think earlier this week we saw Russia's attempt fail, right? They crashed, and India I think had tried previously before also, and they also crashed. And this time they went smoothly, safely, and very slowly and landed.
हिंदी में एक कहावत है कि चंदा मामा दूर के, लेकिन अब हम ये कह सकते हैं कि चंदा मामा अपने घर के।
Amazing.
बहुत ही उम्दा, the hard work of the entire ISRO community has come to fruition.
This is big news for India.
आदरणीय प्रधानमंत्री जी, नमस्कार। सर, वी हैव अचीव्ड सॉफ्ट लैंडिंग ऑन द मून। इंडिया इज ऑन द मून।
Nice. Did they take a flag?
सर,
That's it? No, come on, I need more information. Oh my goodness. Okay. I'm happy that there was this moon landing, but let me see if I can get more information. Guys, I'm so excited. Let's see.
India became the world's first nation to reach the South Pole of the Moon on August 23rd.
Amazing.
India is now on the moon.
People are applauding.
Mission Control erupted in cheers as the Chandrayaan-3 landed in a part of the moon where no country has ever landed before.
For India, it's a matter of national pride.
Yes,
It
national
happened just
pride.
3 days after a similar mission from Russia failed.
It's a blow to the Kremlin because they are trying to show through this mission that Russia is again a superpower.
The lunar South Pole is significant because the expected presence of ice could support future human settlements. Here's
Ice,
why
baby.
Moscow and New Delhi were in a race to get there and how their missions were not just about science, but also about politics. India's Chandrayaan-3, which means moon vehicle in Sanskrit, blasted off from Earth on July 14th.
Lift off normal.
Since then, this spacecraft made several maneuvers around the Earth and has been orbiting the moon to prepare for a landing.
This was like the slingshot method.
Russia launched its Luna 25 less than a month later. It took a much faster and more direct route to the moon and was projected to reach the surface first on August 21st.
Hey,
The South Pole is strategic because the
it's not a
expected presence of
race.
ice could provide fuel, oxygen, and drinking water, making it a potential site for mining and human settlement. But experts say a smooth landing is extremely challenging. That's because the area has much tougher terrain compared to other parts of the moon. It is bumpy, littered with craters, and has limited sunlight.
The lander module has begun its descent.
India tried but failed to reach there 4 years ago and finally succeeded on August 23rd.
See, that's the thing. That's the thing. It's not a race, you know. It's not about being the first. Well, at least it shouldn't be, right? About being the first. It's about being the only one. I mean, India is the first, obviously, but they're the only one at this point. And they took 4 years to try and try again and get it perfect, you know. So this is a great achievement, and it was made by being calm, patient, and working hard and studying and learning from their mistakes, you know. I think Russia just wanted to rush and be first. Maybe if they had been a little bit more patient, maybe they would have landed also.
This success belongs to all of humanity.
Exactly.
And it will help moon missions by other countries in the future.
That makes India the fourth country in the world to reach the moon after the United States, Russia, and China. India is expected to get a lot of offers from other space agencies, foreign countries, to launch like commercial satellites for them, which is going to be also a revenue earner for India.
Amazing. That's going to help the economy. You know, that is awesome. But the main thing is that India is the only one to have reached the South Pole, because everybody else, you know, was probably in the North Pole. Not sure, but still, that's awesome.
A happy landing for Russia's unmanned Luna 17 spacecraft.
Russia was the first country to send a rover to the moon back in 1970, towards the end of a space race between the US and the Soviet Union during the Cold War. But Russia hasn't launched another lunar lander since the 1970s, and the stakes this time around were especially high, more than 18 months after it launched the invasion of Ukraine.
Connectors.
Western sanctions imposed on Russia since the war complicated its collaborations in space with Europe and the US.
Because I know,
of
right?
Sanctions, a lot of the cooperation that used to take part in terms of space projects, they have come to an end. Mm-hmm. And also because of technology export bans, Russia cannot receive a lot of the electronics and other technology that it would have in the past from European nations that supported its space program. So this is extremely significant.
For India, there are political and financial reasons driving its mission to the lunar South Pole. The successful mission could boost Prime Minister Narendra Modi's election campaign early next year.
These kind of missions.
Do you think this is political?
National pride. Prime Minister Modi is going to tell his voters how the country has reached the moon, which would make to his benefit.
The Indian Space Agency worked.
That's interesting. How long has Modi been the Prime Minister, and how long, like, will he be if he is re-elected? And do you guys want him to be re-elected? What are your thoughts?
The Indian Space Agency works on a shoestring budget. In February, the government slashed funding for the Department of Space by 8% to $1.5 billion. In comparison, NASA's budget for 2023 is more than $25 billion.
Bro.
India is hoping to get a lot of foreign collaborations in terms of like offers for joint venture missions to launch commercial satellites. So it relies on these foreign collaborations to support its space missions.
You know, the United States has a lot of money, but the fact that they spend so much of it, you know, like even with movies, they spend so much, and India manages to do that in a fraction of the price. But I think Elon Musk is trying to fix that, right? Elon Musk is trying to make everything more affordable, let's say.
India's successful landing on the lunar South Pole could change its standing in the global space race, especially in Asia.
India's position as a global space power would definitely be reinforced. Definitely puts India ahead of countries like Japan and Korea, and just behind China.
Interesting.
Meanwhile, Russia still has a way to go to catch up with the US and China.
It's not the be-all and end-all for Russia. There are other lunars, Luna 26 and Luna 27. They both depend on electronics from the West. And for as long as sanctions continue, it's going to be difficult for Russia to obtain the kind of technology that it needs to continue collaborating and ensuring that it is number one, as it wants to be, in the space race.
Yo, I'm telling you, India is, man, you guys are very impressive at everything you do, honestly. It is something that you, man, I don't know, I think you study a lot, and you don't allow things to be rushed, you just really study a lot, and I think that's what is the success of a lot of Indian things. Because there are a lot of ways to do the same thing, but with a cheaper budget, let's say. That's what I think, you know. I think it all comes down to studying the best way and the best outcome. And that's it. Guys, you know, I wish my country, Brazil, had so much to be proud of like India does. And, you know, let's see, because, you know, we have a lot of things to be proud of, but India is just in another level right now. Guys, thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Take care now. Bye-bye. Are you happy? Let me know in the comments.
Now you can get full access to exclusive content, special reactions to shows, series, anime, full movies, and even request a video of your choice. Just become a YouTube member or join Buy Me a Coffee today. Find out more, the link is in the description. Never break, always fight, never quit, do it right.